came here and I didn't really know what to expect. And what I saw, small example of your brilliance. I must tell you, I was very, very pleasantly surprised. People say, oh, I'm a politician. And that's like a definition that people give. But that is not really my job. My job is to look at the talent available in the country, students like you, understand their strength, understand their weakness, and help them to achieve the maximum possible. The first part of my job is to understand what youngsters want. Listen carefully to what they want. And the second part of my job is to try and do whatever I can to make them achieve what they desire to achieve.
And now we are following our own state board syllabus and we are appearing public exams and we are achieving high marks. So according to the new education policy, they have decided to set up the National Testing Agency to conduct the entrance exams after 12. So even now we are suffering because of NEET exam. So the dream of rural students like us to become a doctor is a question mark. So what do you say about that, Anna?
The pillars of an education system are students and teachers. And they are both equally important. I'm not currently a student and I'm not a teacher. And I come and tell you how you should study, how you should learn, how you should understand. This is arrogance on my part. Any policy that is made without asking students and teachers what they want is not going to be a policy that is going to benefit education.
If you get a chance to interview our present Prime Minister in front of the public, what will be your first question towards him?
Very interesting
now
question.
You're asking me a tricky question. I would say that India has 1.3 billion people. Huge percentage of the world's population lives in India. Different types of ideas, different types of languages, different types of religions, different types of visions. Why are you convinced that all the answers come from you? Why don't you listen to the people of this country? Why don't you try and understand what this people, what the people of this country are saying? What is the reason for this? That is what I would ask.
My friends and I have a song. Do you like to hear that?
Yeah, as long as you don't make me sing the song.
Okay. Would you dance?
Well.
Yeah. These days, even the press are unable to reveal the truth. The people are getting threatened and beaten at certain times. In the independent India, we are not able to express our thought. Our freedom of expression is being curbed. So my question is, do you think we need another freedom fight to get back our basic rights?
I was thinking exactly that in the car. When I was coming here, I was thinking exactly that. That what India now is going to need is another freedom struggle. But it has to be a non-violent, affectionate freedom struggle. We have to fight the division, the anger and the fear, and once again make India happy, comfortable, fearless and united. Do you want to see some Aikido? Should I show you Aikido?
Ready?
Okay. Oh my God! Awesome! Great! Good, good! Yes! Let's all get lost!
Try with one hand.
One kai vachi nee edukka mudiyuma? Unakku ippa saval
udraare. Second Bruce Lee.
Second Bruce Lee. Oh! Wonderful!
அவரு கூட பேசினதுல எனக்கு ரொம்ப சந்தோஷம். அவரு கூட புஷப் பண்ணேன், அது நினைக்கவும் எனக்கு ரொம்ப சந்தோஷமா இருக்கு.
It's my long day's dream to talk to Rahul Gandhi. Now I'm happy.
It was my great pleasure to interact with such a great leader.
இப்படி ஒரு ட்ரூ லீடரை எங்கள் ஸ்கூலில் வச்சு பார்த்து உங்க கூட பேச ரொம்ப ரொம்ப சந்தோஷமாக இருந்தது.
So it was really great interacting with him. I never dreamt of it, but that was really nice. And he, all the speech he gave was really inspiring. So thank you so much.
It was wonderful interacting with you, Anna.
Thank you, Rahul, Anna.